Let knowledge flow like a river without any hindrance. Don't make it like a stagnant pool. Design an analysis of arthritic cantilever slab as per IS 456. Hello everybody, I'm P.S. Chatterjee with you. Today I am going to explain you how we can make a proforma in Excel spreadsheet for the analysis of cantilever slabs. Minimum requirements for that are IS 456 2000, SV 16-1980, SV 34-1987, IS 875-1987, Excel software 2010, and any standard book. So this is our floor plan and this is our cantilever slab. Edge condition of the cantilever slab. Say this is continuous edge. This is elevation of a cantilever slab. This is UDL, this is point load. The slab having one fixed support or continuous support will be considered as a cantilever slab. Overhanged balcony slabs are the good example of cantilever slab. For safe design, this is span of the cantilever and this is intermediate span. This L must be less than equal to A by 2. Important clauses regarding cantilever slab design. All the important clauses I have discussed in my previous lecture video of design and analysis of 2A RCC slab as per IS 456 is also applicable for cantilever slab. Bending moment and shear force under different support condition. This is a cantilever slab. This is UDLW and this is a cantilever slab. This is point load. Bending moment for UDL WL square by 2, shear force WA into L, bending moment P into L and shear force P. This is the modification factor for tension reinforcement chart. This is also I explained in my earlier videos. Design shear strength of concrete. For solid slab, the design shear strength of the concrete shall be tau CK, design shear stress into K, where K has a value given below. When depth is greater than or equal to 300, then it is 0.1. When it is 275, it is 0.1.05. When it is 250, 1.1, like that. When less than or equal to 150, it is 1.3. Design shear strength of the concrete as per SP 16, tau C, design shear strength of the concrete is equal to 0.85 square root of 0.8 FCK into 1 plus 5 beta minus 1 divided by 6 beta. Beta is equal to 0.8 FCK divided by 6.89 into percentage of steel provided. But this value not less than 1 and PT is equal to 100 into AST divided by B into D. Table 19. Design shear strength of concrete tau C in Newton per millimeter square. This is percentage of steel provided and this is grade of concrete and these are the shear strength of the concrete on the basis of percentage and grade of steel. Now I am switching over to Excel spreadsheet for numerical calculation. Welcome to my Excel spreadsheet for design calculation of cantilever slab. These are the parameters. This is FCK, 20 Newton per millimeter square. This is FY, 415 Newton per millimeter square. Unit weight of concrete, 25 kilonewton per meter cube. Partial factor of safety, 1.5. Concrete cover at support, 20 mm. Concrete cover at span, 20 mm. Minimum percentage of reinforcement, 0.12%. This is XU max by D. This is equal to 0.0035 divided by within bracket 0.0055 plus 0.87 into FY divided by 2 lakh, that is E for steel. MU by limb bidet square is equal to 0.36 XU max D, that is this value, into 1 minus 0.416 XU max D, this value, into FCK. PT limb is equal to round up 100 into 0.36 FCK divided by 0.87 into FY into XU max D up to 3 digit. K1 is equal to 0.1005 divided by 1.15 into FY square divided by FCK. K2 is equal to FY divided by 1.15 minus. Slab mark S1, place first floor, slab length LX is equal to 1.5 meter or 1500 millimeter. Slab thickness we considered 100. 4 finish load 1 kilonewton per meter square. Live load 3 kilonewton per meter square. Other dead load, that is this load P on the edge of the cantilever slab, is 2 kilonewton per meter. Total load is equal to weight of the slab, self weight of the slab, that is thickness of the slab divided by 1000 into unit weight of concrete plus floor finish load plus live load. Reinforcement provided. This is our main bar, dia 8 tall and spacing 100 center to center. This is distribution bar and dia 8 tall and spacing 300 mm center to center. Moment coefficient. Cantilever moment coefficient under UDL is 0.5, that is half. Moment, total moment. Total moment is into this alpha x into W, that is this W, total W, into L square by 2 plus this other load 2 kilonewton into L into partial factor of safety. VU is equal to this load into length, this 1.5 plus this load. MU by BD square is equal to this value, MU into 10 to the power 6 by 1000, that is width B, D means thickness of the slab into 0.5 watt dia minus support cover, round up to 2 digit. Shear stress calculated is equal to this shear force divided by cross sectional area, 100 width, and E minus CP, that is cover at support, and this is thickness. Now percentage required is equal to this formula. AST required is equal to this formula. AST provided is equal to this formula. AST provided is less than AST required. So we need to change this dia. Change spacing. Okay. The percentage of steel provided 1.501. This is more than PT limit, not acceptable. So we have to change the thickness. 125, 150. Now it is okay. Now check for shear stress. This formula beta is equal to, this formula I have already explained in my PowerPoint presentation. And tau c, this formula is also I have explained in my PowerPoint presentation. This is the value of k. This is also I have explained in PowerPoint presentation. Now, k into tau c is equal to 0.779. And here we have k tau c, that is design shear strength. Design shear stress of concrete is equal to 0.779 newton per millimeter square. As per our calculation, shear stress tau v is equal to 0.157 newton per millimeter square. This value is less than this value, so design is okay. At the end, design summary. Minima at support, 10 dia, 75 spacing. At the span, this spacing will be double of this spacing, and distribution bar is 8 to 300. And that's all about my design of cantilever slab. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel and also evaluate my performance with your valuable comments. Thank you.